Arirang Prime.
Jingwasa Temple, located in Seoul, has a millennial history. About a century ago, a mysterious incident occurred here. A Buddhist monk running away from someone. He hides something deep inside a shrine. A small cloth-bound bundle. What's inside it? This Pandora's box remained hidden for more than a century until it was recently discovered, providing clues about its owner. It held the life story of a man whose traces, and even his soul, were nowhere to be found before.
발견됐다는 소식을 접하고 아 바로 할아버지구나. 깜짝 놀랐죠.
아 가슴이 뜨거웠죠. 눈물이 얼컥 솟았습니다.
Here's the story of a Buddhist monk and independence fighter who loved his country with all his heart. Who shared its pain and suffering, and who dedicated his life to protecting it. Nestled at the foot of Bukhansan Mountain in Seoul, Jingwansa Temple, built in 1011, is the living history of Korean Buddhism. Since the ancient times, it has been called a temple of grace because it was built as a royal temple to pray for peace in the nation. In 2009, a treasure was discovered in the temple that stunned the world. It was found in Chilsonggak, the oldest shrine in the temple dedicated to the Great Dipper God.
그 한지로 딱 포장해 갖고는 흙으로 도배를 싹 해버렸어. 저렇게 돼 있죠, 그죠? 네, 저 위치입니다. 이게 이제 흙벽인데요. 흙벽을 이렇게 긁어내고.
Chilsonggak is located in the deepest part of the temple complex that's rarely visited by people. The treasure, an old bundle, was found in the wall behind an altar in May 2009, when the shrine was dismantled for renovation.
그때 제가 이게 이제 들고 오셨는데 뭔가 이만한 뭉치를 열어 보니까 태극의 문양이 먼저 딱 보였습니다.
What was inside it? Wrapped inside were several newspapers and a national flag. What was particularly shocking was that the flag was drawn on top of a Japanese flag. It was presumably made during the Japanese colonial rule of Korea. The patterns on the flag were different from the modern-day version. The newspapers that were found alongside the flag were dedicated to the National Independence Movement. One of them was the Jeju Shinjongbo, which had been unknown in Korea prior to this discovery.
To 태극기 전체적으로 이 불에 그을린 흔적이 있어요. 그래서 이거는 아마 3.1운동 당시 현장에서 사용됐던 태극기일 가능성이 매우 크다. 3.1운동 현장에서 직접 사용되었던 그 태극기가 뭐 거의 없거나 많지 않은데 그런 점에서 우선 3.1운동의 현장성을 가장 극명하게 보여준다는 점에서 의미가 있고요.
This Korean flag was presumably used during the March 1st movement in 1919, aimed at ending Japanese occupation. After Korea was annexed into Japan in 1910, many Korean activists fought for the nation's liberation. On March 1, 1919, the entire nation launched a non-violence protest for Korea's independence from Japan. At the time, many students and people from all walks of life who participated in the protest were arrested by the Japanese and brutally tortured.
이제 이 국내에 그 외국 선교사들이 많이 있었습니다. 이 사람들이 3.1운동이 일어난 것을 보고 두 가지에 놀랐습니다. 하나는 한국, 그 맨손의 한국인들이 전혀 총칼을 두려워하지 않고 독립만세를 부르고 나오는 데 대한 그 숭고한 그 용기, 여기에 감동을 느꼈고, 또 하나는 일본인들의 그 무자비한 잔혹함, 야만성, 여기에 놀랐었습니다. 그래서 일본의 감시망을 뚫고 비밀리에 이 자기들이 목격한 상황들을 이렇게 보고서를 해서 이렇게 해외로 보냈습니다. 그래서 3.1운동은 일본에 대한 서구인들의 시각을 바꾸는 굉장히 결정적인 그 계기가 되었습니다.
Even foreign newspapers covered in detail the desperate situation that was raging in Korea.
And people were, I think in many cases, were not inclined to put too much importance to it. The situation became somewhat different when more was known about the demonstrations. For instance, at a certain moment it became clear that the way the Japanese reacted to the demonstrations was extremely harsh. Kind of violent and cruel in some instances. And when this was reported, and it happened, for instance, through missionaries, Americans who were active in Korea, at that moment, and they start to think about it. What is the meaning of this? How should this, what should we do?
Koreans of various professions, including journalists and religious figures, participated in the March 1st movement. Then was it one of the independence fighters, fleeing from the Japanese oppressors, who had hid the flag in Jingwansa Temple? The distance between Jongno, where the March 1st movement was staged, and Jingwansa Temple is about 13 kilometers. Although located near downtown Seoul, the temple is nestled deep in the mountains, which made it an ideal hideout.
아, 여기서요 이렇게 독립운동의 거점 사찰 수밖에 없는 그 이곳이요 밖에서 보면은 굉장히 아주 시내예요. 그렇지만 안에 들어오면 올수록 깊은 아주 바깥의 사람들도 진관사가 있는지 없는지 몰라요. 지형 자체가 독립운동의 거점 사찰 수밖에 없는 지형입니다.
진간사에 그것이 은닉됐다고 하는 것은 불교 인사들이 독립운동에 겉으로 드러나지 않지만 매우 깊숙하게 그리고 중요한 역할을 담당했다는 것이거든요.
그럼 과연 여기에 누가 이 태극기를 벽 속에 숨겼을까? 그래서 우선에 스님들이 독립운동하신 스님들을 먼저 이렇게 봤습니다.
Who was the Buddhist monk that waved the Korean flag and fought for Korea's independence during the March 1st movement? Bukchon Hanok Village in Seoul is home to a cluster of elegant traditional style houses called Hanok. Standing since the Japanese colonial rule, the neighborhood is a symbolic place in the history of national independence movement. This house used to be home to the Buddhist monk, poet, and freedom fighter Han Yong-un. Han pioneered a resistance movement in the literary sector by writing the poem, The Silence of Love. He also initiated a youth-led independence movement by publishing the Buddhist magazine, Yushim.
만해 한용운을 중심으로 하는 이제 승려들이, 젊은 승려들이 유심사를 중심으로 해서 이제 결집이 되고 뭔가 이제 스터디를 하면서 이들이 결국은 3.1운동의 가장 핵심적인 동력이 되었고 불교계의 각 본사로 이제 선언서나 독립운동의 흐름을 전파하는 심장부가 됩니다.
An Yong-un was one of the 33 national representatives who included Catholic, Protestant, and Buddhist leaders. He was also the one who read the Declaration of Korean Independence. Another Buddhist monk named Baek Yong-sung was also a national representative along with Han, but they were both arrested by the Japanese police.
그 중생이고 백성이고 이제 우리 국민 아닙니까? 이런 중생과 민족이 고통을 받고 나라를 빼앗을 때는 그 중생의 고통을 해결해 주고 중생의 삶의 현장을 온건히 복구를 시켜주는 이런 것을 해야 된다는 당위성이 있거든요. 이것을 우리는 호흡불교 또는 대승불교로 합니다. 또는 이제 민족을 구하는 거기 때문에 민족불교라고 하거든요.
Korean Buddhism stepped in to save the Korean people every time the nation was in danger. This kind of patriotic Buddhism, which protected the nation from war and foreign invaders, is hard to find in other countries practicing Buddhism. Patriotic Buddhism took root in Korea after Buddhist monks of the Goryeo era expelled Mongolian invaders. Since then, whenever foreign countries tried to invade Korea, Buddhist monks were at the forefront of the fight.
경전에는 국가를 잘 다스리고 그 국가에 살고 있는 나라를 잘 다스리면은 그 사람 백성이 편안하고 그래서 국토도 청정하고 이것이 바로 그 호국불교의 최고의 가치를 타지는 인왕경 속에 있어요.
Dongguk University professor Kim Gwang-sik has been studying the history of Buddhist independence movement. When he heard about the discovery of Jingwansa Temple, he zeroed in one particular person.
여기 진관사 마포포기당 승려 백초를 나오잖아. 네?
This is a Japanese classified document that describes the arrest of Buddhist monk Baek Cho-ol.
초월 스님은 지금까지 알려지지도 않고 베일에 쌓인 인물이었습니다. 그러다가 이제 3.1운동이 일어나자 청주 영화사에 계시다가 용성 스님과 이제 만해 스님이 감옥에 들어가니까 불교 독립운동을 진두지휘할 분이 없으니까 분연히 이제 서울로 오셔서 불교계 독립운동을 지휘하신 분입니다.
Records about this Buddhist monk and freedom fighter were found in Japanese classified papers and a prison record card. Photographed during his imprisonment, the person in this picture is none other than Baek Cho-ol. Who was Baek Cho-ol? Baek Oishik is his great-nephew. His father is Baek Cho-ol's nephew. Baek Oishik and his father had been looking for Baek Cho-ol for a long time. But all they could find was just written documents left by the Japanese. Baek Cho-ol lost touch with his family after he became a freedom fighter. His family had no idea if he was dead or alive.
아버님이 이분을 만나 뵙지는 못했지. 여기 박군본 선임이 이제 외정 당시 초월 하상께 수학을 했습니다. 해가지고 이제 1985년 3월 17일 3월 17일 날.
The father and son spent over two decades trying to find traces of their lost relative since the 1980s.
그 전국 그 남한에 있는 사찰은 거의 다 그 뭐 다니시더라고요. 그래 한 번은 그 지리산 쪽에도 그 사찰이 많잖아요. 이제 그쪽에 이제 길을 잘 못 들어가가지고 막 해가 이제 쭉 저물고 이러다 보니까 탈진을 해가지고 그래서 이제 큰 뭐 죽을 고비를 넘겼다.
Even in the Buddhist sector, Baek Cho-ol is a mysterious figure. Ever since his participation in the National Independence Movement became known, many scholars have been trying to find traces of his life. A folding screen, presumably featuring his handwriting, is currently on display at the Suwon Museum.
이거는 임자 하일 여름에 이제 초월이 썼다고 하는 건데 이것도 역시 똑같은 인장이에요. 네, 상당히 수준급이라고 볼 수가 있죠. 그러니까 기본적으로 석기가 없이 나름대로 사군자의 어떤 그 풍모가 아주 간결하면서도 품격 있게 그려져 있는 것 같습니다.
Not only was the Buddhist monk extremely well-read, he also had an extraordinary talent in calligraphy and art. He was a genius of his time and a great Buddhist teacher who never stopped learning.
Yeah. 스님의 삶에서 가장 큰 또 시련 중 하나가 1911년 12월에 이제 그 지리산에 있는 영원사, 본인의 이제 출가 사찰이었던 영원사가 불타서 회진이 돼버리죠. 그러니까 이제 그것에 대한 중창불사를 해야 하는 상황이었기 때문에 뭔가 이런 그림을 그리고 글씨로 뭔가 이렇게 이제 모금 활동을 하는데 했던 것이 아닌가.
Jitisan Mountain, with its magnificent lush scenery and meandering slopes, is regarded as a sacred mountain in Korea. It's home to a millennial temple called Yeongwansa. In the past, it was the largest temple in Jitisan, but its size was reduced drastically by fire. It was the first place that Baekhoy Sheik visited in search of his great uncle.
조사님 뭐 편히 앉으십시다. 앉으시고요.
Baekcho Wol entered Yeongwansa Temple at the age of 14 in 1890. He practiced Buddhism here until he left for Seoul to join the National Independence Movement. His traces can be found here even though 100 years have passed. He is mentioned in the book Joshilolo, which contains records about senior priests who served at Yeongwansa Temple. It serves as further proof that Baekcho Wol was a renowned monk. It is the only material that provides detailed information about Baekcho Wol. The book records that at age 28, Baekcho Wol was a resident master, which means that he was already highly knowledgeable and revered in his late 20s. At the time, his Buddhist name was Chowo Hwasan.
Jinju-in, 법원 남파 화상한테 예 받은 거예요.
His fight against the Japanese began while he was still at Yeongwansa Temple. At the time, the Japanese tried hard to destroy Korean Buddhism. Temples located in Jirisan Mountain were among their targets. Baekcho Wol did everything he could to protect Korean Buddhism. Many monks came to learn from him. He also visited many famous temples in Korea to teach other monks about their responsibilities and the spirit of Korean Buddhism. In 1915, he was named a lecturer at the first modern Buddhist school, Jungang Hangnim. But Baekje Wol had to return to Yongwonsa. The temple, which was his spiritual home, was nearly destroyed in a fire. He launched a campaign to raise money for its restoration. Preserving this millennial temple, which was like a living proof of Korean Buddhism, was vital for carrying on the religion. One day, the news about the March 1st movement reached the remote Yongwonsa Temple. Upon hearing the news, Baekje Wol hurriedly left for Seoul.
Finally, it's the day when my dream will come true.
서울에 1919년 4월에 이제 3.1운동 직후에 그 불교의 독립운동이 전국적으로 확장이 되겠다는 이제 소식을 가지고 이제 서울에 오셨는데 서울에 오시기 전에는 이제 뭐 강사랄까 조실이랄까 이렇게 이제 후학들만 가르치다가 3.1운동이 일어나니까 이제 불교계도 말이지 천도교라든가 기독교처럼 독립운동을 더 해야겠다. 또 용성 스님과 한용운 스님이 감옥에 들어가신 상태라 내가 나서서 독립운동을 진두지휘했다.
Then why did Baekje Wol hide the national flag in Jingwansa Temple? Jingwansa was the stronghold of his independence activities. Sometimes he climbed to the top of the mountain behind the temple to reaffirm his determination.
북글씨만 서셨답니다. 북글씨만 서시고 말씀이 없으시고 그러는데 이제 도량에 포행을 하시면 뒷짐을 지고 저 삼각산은 우리 조선인데 외놈은 계란이야. 우리 조선의 독립은 언제 될까? 이런 말씀을 재연하시면서 또 막 눈물을 흘리시는 거예요.
He prayed for Korea's freedom. One night he returned badly injured and bleeding all over. He was close to fainting because he had lost much blood. What happened to him that day? In March 1921, newspapers reported on the arrest of the person who was raising campaign funds. Baekje Wol was behind the action. At the time, Baek dispatched monks to the provisional government in Shanghai and freedom fighters in Manchuria. He also traveled all over the country to raise campaign funds and send them to China.
서울에 있는 이제 그 학인 스님들, 3.1운동에 참가한 학인 스님들을 이제 진두지휘해서 각 절로 보내가지고 돈, 군자금을 받아오게끔 하고 또 모여진 군자금을 상해 임시정부로 보내고 또 만주 독립군으로 보내고 이렇게 활동했습니다.
After the March 1st movement, a provisional government was established in Shanghai, China. Freedom fighters were preparing thoroughly for an armed rebellion. Baekje Wol acted as a link between the provisional government and the Buddhist sector. Despite being a primary target of the Japanese police, he continued to expand his independence activities. He set up a secret organization in order to raise campaign funds in a more systematic way. He also launched the publication of a secret bulletin to raise awareness of anti-Japanese movement, not only in the Buddhist sector, but among the common people as well. To avoid Japan surveillance, he pretended to be a regular monk and raised funds at Buddhist gatherings.
독립운동을 하게 되면 군자금이 또 필요하잖아요, 그죠? 여기가 이제 4대 명찰이기 때문에 법회를 하기 참 좋은 사람들을 모아서 법회하기 좋은 장소였고 법회를 하다 보면 스님이 이제 너무 대종사요 또 대선사였기 때문에 그냥 사람들이 그 스님의 법문을 듣고 환희심을 내고 번뇌를 내려놓고 이러면서 많은 시주를 하게 됐을 것 같아요.
His Buddhist gatherings were popular to the extent that they were even introduced in newspapers. He visited temples all over the country to hold gatherings and to raise campaign funds. His absence in the Buddhist independence movement was unimaginable. But his fundraising activities were soon detected by the Japanese police. Baekje-wol was arrested and put through excruciating torture. A ruthless, high-ranking Japanese officer who had been eager to catch him practiced unspeakable methods. Baek even developed a mental disorder because the Japanese often burned his head with a soldering iron. He was finally released from prison, but remained under Japan's strict surveillance. But was it the after effects of torture? He began to show strange symptoms. He brought a dead turtle to his room and took care of it as if it were his pet. Every night, he would talk to the turtle. People said he was mentally unwell as a result of the torture. Even the Japanese police, who had been closely following his every move, decided to drop their guard.
너무 너무 이제 이 나라를 구하기 위해서 거북구자 나라국자를 썼답니다. 구할구자를 쓰면 일본 사람들의 눈에 들키겠니까. 그래서 그 거북이와 이렇게 대화를 하셨답니다. 스님께서 그러면서 약간 좀 이렇게 일부러 미친 척도 하시고 그래서 그 일본 순사의 망을 교란시키고 이런 것도 있으셨습니다.
Japanese officers have finally left the temple. They seem sure that I have lost my mind. It's time for me to resume my duties and regain my country.
The brutal torture would plague him for the rest of his life, but he never once backed down from the fight for his country's freedom. The more Japan tried to oppress Korea, the stronger was his resistance. Moved by his actions, more and more Buddhist monks joined the National Independence Movement. The Buddhist sector even issued a declaration of Korea's independence. Then why did Baekje-wol hide a national flag in Chilsonggak Shrine of Jingwansa Temple? He was arrested and released by Japanese police several times. That's why Jingwansa, a stronghold of his freedom fight, was also under the Japanese police surveillance. He did not want to put others at Jingwansa in danger, so he hid the precious flag and materials on the independence movement deep in Chilsonggak, where no one was likely to find it.
급히 태극기 안에 그런 문서들을 이렇게 싸가지고 뭐 일제가 샅샅이 뒤질 테니까 웬만한 데다 숨겨서는 안 되겠다. 그래서 이제 상대적으로 서울 외곽에 있던 진관사, 그것도 이제 대웅전 같은 데는 어떻게 될지 모르니까 남들이 잘 주목하지 않는 칠성각, 그 거기도 이제 부처님 불상을 모시기 위해서 만들어진 단을 뜯어내고 밑에다 놓으면 또 상할지도 모르니까 벽에다가 이렇게 붙여놓고 다시 각을 해서 아마 그렇게 은닉을 시켜뒀는데 그거 발설했다가는 발각됐다가는 큰탈이 나는 거죠.
영화사 temple was built over 110 years ago during the Korean Empire. During his search, Baekhoy Sheikh learned that his great-uncle had stayed at this temple for quite a long time. Baekcho-wol had to leave Jingwansa because of the close surveillance of the Japanese police. At Yanghwasa, he fostered junior priests and focused on his missionary work. What looked like missionary work on the outside was in fact a preparation for independence movement. At Yanghwasa Temple, Baekcho-wol attained an important enlightenment about the future course of his actions.
Gangsa로 계시면서 복음 활동도 하고 그다음에 도학을 양성시키면서 함경에 있는 일신교 교리를 깨달았다고 그런 말씀을 하신 적이 있습니다.
One day, Baekcho-wol was reading the Flower Garland Sutra to recover balance in body and mind. He came across a phrase that struck him like lightning. It was Tongmanbap Myeongilshim, which means to reveal one's mind through insight on the law of all things of the world. Baekcho-wol discovered the path of his fight in the word Ilshim, meaning one mind.
Ilshim, anything is possible in one mind. If our people unite in one mind, one will, we can and we will achieve independence.
He set up a secret organization called the Ilshim Association that reflected his anti-Japanese philosophy. He traveled all over the country to collect funds and members. Jingwansa Temple was the center stage of this association. Baekcho-wol toured the nation to teach the public about his beliefs. People from across the nation joined his independence movement and funds came flooding in.
그러한 독립운동을 한두 번만 한 것이 아니고 이걸 지속시키기 위해서 항일 비밀 결사를 만들었습니다. 일심에 한 마음으로 뭉치자. 한 마음으로 독립운동하면 독립이 가능하다는 일심회를 만들어서 일심교회 정신으로 학인세미라 할까 불교 청년들을 결속시켜가지고 비밀 지하 조직을 만들어서 결정적인 순간에 독립운동도 하고 지속적으로 독립운동을 할 수 있는 배후 세력을 조직을 했습니다.
His traces are found even in Odaesan Mountain in Gangwon-do Province. 울정사 temple, built in 643, is known as a cradle of Korea's independence movement along with Jingwansa. Baekcho-wol stayed here in 1936 as a lecturer. The reason he visited Uljongsa was quite special. He came here to meet with a Buddhist figure who collaborated with him in the independence movement. Lee Jong-uk from Uljongsa Temple represented the Shanghai Provisional Government in Gangwon-do Province. He was one of the major Buddhist independence activists.
분리의 초석을 다짐해서 보이지 않게 독립 자금과 흥금과 성금을 이제 그 건네면서 비밀스럽게 후원한 그런 역사를 가지고 있습니다.
Lee Jong-uk and Baek Cho-wol collaborated on many levels, delivering funds to the Shanghai Provisional Government shortly after the March 1st movement. When training junior monks at Woljeongsa, Baek Cho-wol stressed his philosophy of Ilshim.
We must unite. If we can achieve anything, if all of us, including monks and ordinary Buddhists, unite in one mind, if 30 million Koreans unite, we can achieve independence. If the entire world unites, we can even achieve world peace.
이제 초월심의 특이한 점은 불교 사상을 변형, 재해석을 해서 그걸 설명해주고 예, 그러한 뜻으로 그 어떤 그 독립의 그 마음이 있는 그 이제 불교 청년들을 결합을 해가지고 독립 현장에 보내고 예, 어떤 독립운동에 경각심을 주고 미래를 준비한 예, 그렇게 볼 수가 있습니다. 예, 다시 말하면 예, 불교 정신으로 독립운동을 나가게끔 추동하고 촉매하고 만들고 실천했다. 이렇게 볼 수가 있습니다.
One day, something unexpected happened in Odaesan Mountain. Baek Cho-wol stopped in his tracks and started shouting. His shout for freedom was his unswerving determination to make his dream come true, to liberate his country, whatever it cost him. But yet another trial was waiting for it. In 1937, Japan staged a massive warfare against China. The two countries put everything at stake to win the war, which consisted of numerous deadly battles. Japan sent young Koreans and materials to the battlefield. Korea acted as a supplier of soldiers and materials to China and Manchuria. The incident happened in October 1939. A train carrying military supplies and soldiers bound for Manchuria was waiting at Yongsan Station in Seoul. One man was seen scribbling something on the train. He looked around nervously and wrote with caution. Who was he, and what was he writing? He was none other than a station worker. His suspicious behavior caught the eye of Japanese police. Suddenly, the station turned into a chase scene. What exactly did the man write on the train? It was a phrase, "Hurrah, Korea's independence." Japanese police were shocked. All the police officers at the station were deployed to catch the man.
가장 유명한 게 1937년 10월 달에 용산에서 만주로 가는 군용 열차에 대한 독립 만세라는 낙서를 씀으로써 일본 군대 끌려가는 청년들에게 경각심을 불러주고 일제에게도 간담이 서늘하게 민족이 살아있다 라는 사실을 각인시킨 유명한 그 거사가 있었죠.
Some 80 people were detained in the incident. too many to be caught just for scribbling. But there was one person who masterminded the incident. The verdict that was issued to Park Soon-nam, the man who wrote on the train, accused him of being a member of the Ilshim Association led by Baek Jo-wol. October 1939, Baek Jo-wol was arrested and imprisoned yet again for the train incident.
그 거사로 인해서 이제 초월신문과 함께 그 독립운동 하던 스님들이 80명이 끌려가서 고문받고 그랬습니다. 그래서 이제 그 고문의 후유증으로 그 마포 포교당의 그 이제 주지스님하고 또 초월심의 명령을 받들어서 이제 낙설한 그 노동자 또 어떤 여학생 이 세 명은 고문치사로 이제 죽음을 당했고 예, 그리고 이제 초월심도 이제 그때 끌려와서 3년 동안 이제 서대문 형무소에서 가져서 이제 옥고를 치르다가
Again, he was subjected to brutal torture. After serving 2 years in prison, he was finally released. But very soon, he was apprehended again. This time for his involvement in independence campaign funds sent to Manchuria. Even excruciating torture could not curb his determination to fight for his country. Nor did he shrink before the Japanese police, who tried to break his spirit in vain. Baek Jo-wol was sent to Cheongju Prison. Wounds covered his body, but he remained dauntless, an intimidating figure for the Japanese police. For over two decades, Baek Jo-wol was repeatedly arrested, imprisoned, tortured, and closely watched. In June 1944, unable to endure more suffering, he died in his prison cell. All that he left to this world was a single photo of himself and a national flag that bore his one wish, Korea's independence. 1 year after his death on August 15, 1945, Korea finally became a free country. His strong belief that anything could be achieved if people came together had been right.
승리의 길이 순국까지 가는 것이었지만 그것이 결국은 우리한테 던지는 큰 울림은 나 자신만을 위한 것이 아닌 함께 더불어 이제 민중들과 함께 하는 고통을 함께 하는 사연이었다는 거죠.
부처님의 뜻이라는 게 같은 고통받는 다수 와 함께 하는 것이라고 한다면 그 정신을 보살행으로 실천행으로 옮겨서 자기가 정의롭지 못한 측면에 대해서 정말 부처님 정신에 입각해가지고 그들과 더불어서 문제를 해결하고 맑고 향기로운 정말 사회를 만들기 위해서 좀 더 적극적이고 진취적으로 나아가야 되지 않을까 이렇게 생각하고 있습니다.
But Baek Jo-wol was nowhere to be found in his free country. Efforts to find his remains were futile, and after the Korean War, they disappeared forever. In 1991, more than 50 years after his death, a monument was erected in his honor. His fiery life, dedicated to his country and his nation, was still giving light and hope.
Our 이제 불교의 궁극적 목표는 행복이거든요. 행복, 행복이 일심의 사상입니다. 어린아이든 남녀노소, 곤충, 미물, 곤충, 준동함령이라 그러죠. 모두가 다. 환희롭고 행복한 그런 세계, 그런 세계가 일심의 사상입니다.
Baek Jo-wol set the example of a religious figure whose actions speak louder than words. he gave courage to the Korean nation to come together and make its dream come true. Venerable Baekje-wol has left this world, but his teachings still resonate in our hearts.